In this video, you're going to learn a few easily overlooked techniques to turn your Twitter tweets into a flood of traffic to your web pages and blogs. So let's go ahead and get on into it. One of the ways in which we can increase the flow of traffic to our Twitter page, which hopefully in turn will result in a flow of additional traffic to our website or blog via the URL here in our bio section, is to submit our Twitter page to AutoPing services. Because AutoPing services are not just, as some may think, for blog posts or website updates. Because, frankly, what is Twitter but a microblog? So let's take a look at a couple of more of the popular ones, AutoPinger and Ping-O-Matic. Now, if you think about this as a blog, then most of the time you have an auto submit type setup on your blog so that every time you hit your post button after you've completed writing your post, then it is automatically sent, depending upon how you have your blog set up, it's automatically sent out to some of these auto ping services or just the services like Technorati or a host of a gazillion other ones out there. Well, here, let me just show you. For example, AutoPinger, get this guy out of the way here. We've got a whole bunch of options here. Of course, they're all by default checked. Technorati, Feedburner, My Yahoo. I wish it would stop that. But anyway, I can't hold my mouse over these because it'll start popping the things up there. But you can see what I mean. So by submitting your Twitter page to all of these sites via the AutoPing service, named in this case AutoPinger, then each one of these services here are going to get a notice saying, hey, this guy just updated his Twitter page. Go check it out. Or as you are more familiar with, hey, this guy just updated his blog page, go check it out. Now you can do the same thing with Ping-O-Matic. There is a bit of a difference though. They're both free services, but with Ping-O-Matic, whenever you submit, you get a notification saying a submission took place. Basically, that was pretty much it. Now with AutoPinger, it tells you what takes place. Yes, it lets you know that the submission took place, but it also tells you if it was successful, if it was not successful, and a little bit as to why. So let's go ahead and first off try the AutoPinger service. And unfortunately, you do not want to do this more than once a day. Maybe even take it back a notch or two and do it maybe a couple of times a week. And whenever you do it, make sure that you've just submitted, well, that particular day, for example, at least a few fresh tweets. In other words, you don't want to submit it on a Monday after having only submitted some tweets on Sunday and then go to AutoPinger again on Wednesday and not have any additional tweets in there since the last time you submitted it to the AutoPinger service. So the only way this is going to really help you is if you use Twitter. And if by that I mean being a member of the community, submit some quality content. By submitting quality content a couple of times a day, two or three times a day, at the very least once a day, even if it's just a matter of saying good morning, hello, how are you. Of course, you may want to take it a step further, but at the very least that, then the services of AutoPinger will help you more so than if you just kind of lay by the wayside and you don't have any updates on your Twitter page and you expect a service such as AutoPinger or Ping-O-Matic to perform miracles. It ain't gonna happen, folks. So after you have submitted some quality tweets to your Twitter page, then head on over to AutoPinger. Now, wait a minute, you're asking yourself, this is not a blog because it says ping your blog now. Well, it kind of sort of is, as I had mentioned. Now, what we want to do here is first off, get on back over to our Twitter page. And we come on down to the very bottom here. This is what I'm looking for right here. And if we just click on this, and then we click on this, this is our link right here. Copy link location. Use Ping-O-Matic. And again, you don't want to do both of these on the same day. And after I show you what AutoPinger is going to look like, then just know that Ping-O-Matic will do the same thing, only it will show you the results differently, like a lack of. In this case, under blog name, you can put whatever name you want. Put your name, put the name of your Twitter page. In my case, it's Hot Peppers or Pepper Picker. The blog homepage what you would do here, in my case, is the HTTP twitter.com/pepperpicker, whatever your username is, after the twitter.com. And then the RSS URL is the one that we just put in there, and the other one right here. Okay, so this one in this case would be, and then this one here, whatever. You get the idea. So the main thing though is the RSS and or the blog homepage, just so that whenever these guys submit to all of the ones you check here, then they're going to know where to send the traffic back to. Okay, so with Auto Pinger, there we go. Okay, so here you can do the same thing as with Ping-O-Matic, whereas you can put in whatever title you so desire. You can put in the URL to your Twitter page, as we just did, and the feed. So let's go ahead and do that here. Let me show you where I'm getting this from, just so you know I'm not making stuff up here. And let me copy this in first. This is our feed. And then we head on back here, go back a step, and right here. If you click on profile, and basically this takes us to our page where it shows just our tweets. Because if you go to home, this is going to show the public timeline, which is basically everybody's tweets that you are following. And that's not going to do you any good, because as you can see up here, that's not your URL. That's everybody's URL that you are following. So you want to go to profile. And this shows your tweets, and this is what you're wanting people to see. Because as you update and provide quality content via your tweets, this is where just yours are going to show up. And of course, they will also show up on the public timeline, but this is for the pinging services here. So you could just click on this and right click, and then left click on copy, or a host of other means in which you can copy this, or you can just do like I just did and just type it in from memory. But that's where this comes from here. And then the title, again, whatever you want. Hot Pepper Picker is the one I'm going to go with. Say that 3 times fast. Okay, and again, tick the ones that you want, untick the ones you don't want, but this is where we're going to go. And then the non-English services, if you feel that's not your cup of tea, then untick them. I'm just going to leave them ticked because, well, they were ticked when I got here, so why not? So we're going to start the ping. Give it a second or three. See what has happened here. Here we go, and you can see it's still doing its thing here on some of these. As you can see, we get the OK or fail, and whenever you get the fail, then you can see that some of them are going to be a little bit different than others as to the reason why. Actually, I've never heard of this one here, but the underlying connection was closed, an unexpected error occurred on a receive. So that might be, since it was not on the send, it was on the receive, it's probably on their end. Feedster, unable to connect to the remote server. On a host of other reasons. Thanks for the ping. The update to Hot Pepper Picker has been updated in our database. We use parameters, yada, 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 and so on and so forth. Okay. So, anyway, you get the idea. As we're coming down here, we can see that some of them did, some of them did not. So, rather than having go through to each one of these companies individually and doing this, you got a server such as AutoPinger or Ping-O-Matic that'll do it all for you. Now, is this going to send floods of traffic to your Twitter page? Possibly not, but if you have quality content on your Twitter page and new, fresh quality content on a regular basis, then over time, this will build your following. And of course, the more people you have following you, is the more eyes that will be poking into your URL on your bio, you know, be it your blog or your website. And of course, the more followers you have, every time that you post a marketing blurb, something about the upcoming launch of your new product, or you get the idea, the more people are going to be seeing it, and of course the more positive reaction into your bank account will occur. Now again, if we were to do the same thing with Ping-O-Matic right now, we stand the chance of getting banned from most of these, because if you ping the heck out of these guys, then they're just going to get tired of it. And, you know, they may even have some kind of an auto ban algorithm set up so that if they see that you are trying to ping too much in the hopes of getting more traffic, then they're just going to say, "Yeah, shut this guy down." In which case, your Twitter page will be banned from all of these services that would do that. So we don't want to push that. Again, it's not worth it. This is just one additional method in which you can increase the number of followers to your Twitter page, which, again, as I've pointed out, will hopefully also increase the number of visitors to your blog and/or website via the URL that you have on your Twitter page. Now, this is going to bring us to the end of this video on using auto ping services to increase your followers. Thank you much for watching.